The clashes have affected villages of Emba, Linyamiro, Etai and Goburu in Gwere North Parish, Lofori Sub-County in Moyo District, and Feo Village in Mburumburuchi Parish, Kochi Sub-County in Yumbe District.
Had the attack on the Ugandans along the border, and then that led into retaliation attacks also from the Ugandans living in that area. This happened on Sunday night. By morning, we intervened as a government.
According to Gofin Gore, the resident district commissioner for Moyo, the clashes started on Monday, 8th May 2023, when a group of youth from the Kuku tribe in South Sudan, claiming that Ugandans have settled in their area, burnt over 17 houses belonging to Ugandans.
We received information that there was a violent clashes along the borderline, especially in the place called Gwere North Parish.
This provoked Ugandans in the affected villages to also attack the South Sudanese, hence worsening the situation.
On Monday evening, we hosted the population there amounting to 300 to 400 citizens of Uganda who are displaced because of that.
No one has lost life in the clashes, although 9 Ugandans were captured by South Sudanese, but later released them, as Gore explains.
Good enough, we have not lost any life. All those who were involved, they are those who got injuries. A number of 9 Ugandans were intercepted by the South Sudanese youth, especially the Kuku youth, who were involved in this confusion.
Property, including animals, have been lost during the clashes. The resident district commissioner for Moyo has revealed that they've put in place a district disaster committee working closely with the office of the prime minister to ensure basic support is given to the victims.
And identify the necessary logistical support that needs to be raised to support the people who are displaced there. And the office of the Prime Minister has already come in. The District Disaster Committee is working out.
Victims of the clashes have narrated their incidents. What hurts most is that the South Sudanese are getting support from their government, unlike us. It is as if we don't have a government. On Sunday, the commissioner of Kajokiji moved with his people to attack us. The people of South Sudan have told us that we were in their land. They forced us out, burnt our houses, and we are suffering without help. I have been here for over 5 years. We've never crossed into South Sudan. We are still in Uganda, but the South Sudanese have come to fight us. They burnt all our houses with our property inside. We have stayed here at the barracks for 3 days now, but we don't have food, no clothes, and our children need to go to school. We don't know where to start from. Report compiled by Adam Gule for the news.